If you are looking for that thick Neve sound and you don't want to break the bank, watch my review of this great sounding Warm Audio 273 EQ channel strip. Before we start, please subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so you know when there's a new video online on this channel, a channel to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. The Warm Audio 273 EQ has two channels which are identical. First thing you see are the microphone inputs on the front. And let's get over these six white switches. The first one you see is the phantom power switch, which engages phantom power on the microphone inputs on the front and the back. And then we have the polarity switch, which inverts the phase. Then we have the tone up, which changes the input impedance and how the transformer works, which affects the sound. And here's the line switch, which cuts the mic and selects the line input. And with the insert, you enable the insert if you have connected it. It inserts after the preamp before the EQ. And then we have the instrument input, which enables you to use the instrument input as a DI and bypasses the microphone and line inputs. Let's go over the other controls. Let's continue with the EQ and the mic preamp section. First up is the mic gain, which is nicely stepped. Then we have a high pass knob, which is also nicely stepped. This one is always engaged. Okay, let's go to the three band EQ. First off, we have a low shelf, which has a stepped frequency selector and a normal gain control. Then we go to the mid band range, which is also stepped for the frequency selection and a normal knob for the gain. And then we have a high shelf, also stepped, and a normal rotary pot for the gain. And with this knob, you can enable or disable the EQ. And here we have the output volume control and the on and off button. These are the controls on the back. First, we have a microphone input. If you connect a microphone on the front, this will be disengaged. We've got line inputs. You got insert send and insert return on separate jacks, which is a nice feature. And here are the outputs on either XLR or a balanced stereo jack, which is a nice touch. And this is the ground lift switch to eliminate ground loops if needed. And now for the important part, how does it sound? Let's check it with snare drum, bass guitar, floor tom, vocal and on the master bus. I will use the WA273 EQ as a hardware insert in Cubase. Let's start with the snare drum. This is the original snare. And now I'll insert the WA273. Even without tweaking, you already notice there's a little bit more beef to the snare drum sound. And let's tweak it now. I will put it on a loop. You can hear, you can really shape the sound of a snare drum with the warm audio. You can go from subtle warmth to really aggressive. Let's do it now. If you drive the input a lot, the saturation and distortion will kick in and you will shave off some of the transients. If you go for that sound, you don't even have to use a compressor. Let's go over to the bass guitar. The bass guitar was already recorded with Warm Audio. It's my passive PV bass guitar and I ran it directly into the direct input of the Warm Audio preamp. I used the gain and the EQ of the Warm Audio to shape the tone of the bass guitar and I added a little bit of compression later. The Warm Audio really brings this bass to life. This bass guitar tends to sound a bit dull when used clean. So a little bit of gain, EQ, and I added a bit of compression later, and it sounds like this. And for the sake of this review, let's play around with the warm audio again. This makes the bass guitar even fuller. The little bit of clipping you heard was already in the recording. Let's go to a floor tom now. And this floor tom was part of a mix I had to do for a band. And the original floor tom sound was really thin and brittle, and I needed a fuller floor tom sound to fit in the mix. I used the warm audio to make that happen. Let's check it out. Here is the floor tom in a solo. Okay, let's loop the floor tom and use the warm audio. Even with this little bit of tweaking, I went from a thin and brittle floor tom to a full sounding floor tom. The original floor tom almost sound out of phase now. Okay, let's go to a vocal. The vocal here was recorded clean with a tube microphone. Let's tweak around with the warm audio.
With your deep red eyes, begging me for more. I must be some kind of god to you, the things you do just to score. Telling me that you'll do everything, but I don't need that ass. I can give you everything you need, I just want your cash. Come to me with your deep red eyes, begging me for more. I must be some kind of god to you, the things you do just to score.
So by increasing the gain and playing with the EQ, the vocal is more concert and has more push. Little tweaks do a lot with the warm audio. And finally, let's check out the warm audio 273 EQ on the master bus in mid-side mode. It does not support mid-side by itself, but I will use the Vocengo MSED plugin to make the warm audio into a mid-side unit. Check my review here. Small tweaks with the EQ give great results, and you can easily overuse it, so be careful with that one. The reason why I chose this unit is because it's flexible and fits my workflow. I need to record, mix and master, and I can use it in all three situations. I can always record two microphones from the recording room by using the microphone inputs at the back. And if I need to record from my mixing room, I can use the front. It will cut out the other microphones. I use it as an insert effect in Cubase by using the line input, so I can select a line. And when I need to record the DI, I will use the DIs of the Warm Audio. So with all this connectivity and the sound you get, I think this is a real good buy for your studio. Thank you for watching this review of the Warm Audio 273 EQ channel strip. If you liked this review, please also check out my review of the Other Audio headphones. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and like this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye!